Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Narayana Live Classes. Today, we are going to discuss solutions of assignment number 15. First question. How many tangents can a circle have? How many tangents can a circle have? For a circle, you can draw any number of tangents. Okay. You can draw any number of tangents. So, we have infinite number of tangents can be drawn to a circle. For a circle, you can draw infinite number of tangents. Coming to the second question. In the second question, we have that's the finger length, right? In that we have four questions. Let us begin with the first one. A tangent to a circle intersects between dash points. So a tangent to a circle intersects exactly at one point. Okay, exactly at one point. Second one. A line intersecting a circle at two points is called a circle. If a line intersects a circle at two points, it is called a the 2 points, it is called as a secant. Coming to the third one, a circle can have dash parallel tangents. Third one, a circle can have dash parallel tangents. So, for a circle, wherever you take, we can draw two parallel tangents. See, these two tangents which are parallel to each other. Coming to the question 4, the common point of a tangent to a circle and the circle is called. Now, the common point where the tangent meets the circle. The common point where the tangent meets the circle. This is the point that is common. This is called as point of contact. So, this is the point of contact. Now, this is these are the questions of second question. This is blanks completed. Coming to the third one. Third question. A tangent PQ at a point P of a circle of radius 5 cm meets a line through the center O at point Q. So that OQ equal to 12 centimeters. See here. This is a filler based question. Center of circle. Right. Here is a point Q. And here is a point P. Q is the external point. And this is the point where this line is. Q touches the circle. It's nothing but a tangent. And OP is given as the radius of the circle. Right. And this external distance is 12 centimeters and OB is given for as 5 centimeters. So if you observe properly, we know it clearly. The radius and the point, the radius in the tangent where they meet exactly, they make an angle of 90 degrees. Right? And very much important thing to be observed is from here, this is 90 degrees, so this becomes a right, OPQ becomes a right angle triangle. So this is the hypotenuse part what we have. Now we have to find out the length of QP. To find out the length of QP, QP square is equal to, what is the formula you will have? OQ square minus OP square. Right? Actually, this is according to the Pythagoras theorem. OQ square is equal to QP square plus OP square. From this, QP square is equal to, we have OQ square minus OP square. That means, QP square is equal to, that is 12 square minus 5 square. So, QP square is equal to 144 minus 25, which gives you QP square is equal to 119. So from here QP is equal to root 119. So which is nothing but the fourth option in that. Now coming to the question number 4. Question number 4 is just a figure based question part. Draw a circle and two lines parallel to the given circle such that one is a tangent and other is a secant. One circle is given for you and one extra line is given. For this line, we have to draw a tangent and a secant parallel to this. So, if you want to draw it, this is a tangent which meets a circle exactly at one point, M. This is a tangent which is parallel to the given line, and this is a secant which is touching the circle at two points. So, we have drawn one tangent and one secant to this circle to the given line. So, this completes question number 4. Coming to the fifth question. This is a theorem. What is the theorem? Prove that length of the tangents drawn from an external point to a circle are equal. This is one important question, important theorem part. So let us prove this one. Circle, an external point. Let us suppose take this external point as A. From here, two tangents are drawn to the given circle. They are meeting at, let us suppose they are meeting at P and Q. Now, I am joining this OA, OP and OQ represents radius of the circle. Now what you have to prove in this theorem? We have to prove that this the length of these two tangents are equal. That means AP is equal to AQ. So given part, given a circle with center O, a circle with center O, and AP and AQ, A is the external point, AP and AQ are the tangents. AP and AQ are the tangents. So what I have to prove? I have to prove that the length of those two tangents are equal. That means I have to prove it as AP is equal to AQ. Now next, is there any construction part? Just small thing, nothing but join OP and OQ. Join OP and OQ. Now let us go for the proof. So let me continue here. Proof part. Consider two triangles AOP and AOQ. Triangle AOP and triangle AOQ. Consider these two triangles. In these two triangles, it is clear that OA is common for both. It's a common side, and OP is equal to OQ. Those are nothing but radius of the circle. And the angle formed here at the point of contact, radius and the tangent at the point of contact is always 90 degrees. So angle OBA is equal to angle OQA is equal to 90 degrees. Right? So according to RHS axis, RHS convergence theorem, what we can tell? We can tell that triangle AOB is congruent to triangle AOQ. So therefore, since they are congruent, the remaining sides of those two triangles will always be equal. So what is the left over remaining side? AP and AQ. So therefore, what you can tell? AP is equal to AQ. This is an important theorem here. Hence, this one is completed. Coming to the next sixth question. Question number 6. If the radii of two concentric circles, radii of two concentric circles are 4 cm and 5 cm. Okay. So let us take two concentric circles. What are concentric circles? Circles having same center. Right? Two circles having same center are called as concentric circles. Now, here two circles of radii 4 cm and 5 cm. Find the length of each chord of one circle which is a tangent to the other circle. Now, see, this is the radius of the external circle and this is the radius of the internal circle. A, B is about, O is the center of the circle, right? So this is given for this. External circle is nothing but 5 cm and the internal one is 4 cm. Here AB is the chord and this AB chord touches the internal circle at one point, let us suppose it as P. Now, if you observe properly, AB is the chord, I have to find out this length of the chord AB. Now AB is a chord which touches the circle, the internal circle at one point. So AB becomes a tangent. Okay. So now what I have to find? I have to find out the length of this chord. So in the same way, if you want, you can join this. And by comparison between these two triangles, we can prove directly that AB is equal to PB. Okay. So first what I will do, I will find out this AB and I will double that, I will get the value of AB. So from this, what we can do from triangle AOP? From triangle OAP, right, OA square is equal to OP square plus AP square. From here, AP square is equal to OA square minus OP square, that is nothing but 5 square minus 4 square. So AP square is equal to 25 minus 16. So from here, AP square is equal to 9. From here, AP is equal to root 9, that is AP is equal to root 9, that is 3. So I got the AP value as 3. Now once I get this AP value, now I have to find out AP. How to find out this AP? We know it clearly that to find out this AP value, what I have to do? Simple thing is AB is nothing but twice that of AP. Right? So that is nothing but 2 into 3, that will give you 6 cm. So this is the length of the chord AB. Right. Thank you.